One of my more popular videos is one I did way back in 2010 called Audio Frequency Response of LP versus CD. As of when I'm making this video, that video has 281,000 views and quite a lot of comments on it. And over the years, a number of people have argued that when I was showing the frequency response of a vinyl LP, they argue that anything above 20,000 hertz, or sometimes they even say anything above 16,000 hertz, is just noise and distortion and doesn't actually contain any useful audio information. But there's one way to prove that is to play an LP that was digitally recorded, especially one from the 1980s when they didn't have higher sampling rates, so they were pretty much limited to the same frequency response as a CD. So I have an LP from 1986 here. It doesn't say it was digitally recorded, but it is evident when I'm playing it. This is right here, 20,000 hertz, the same limit as a CD. And you can see the audio has a sharp cutoff at 20,000 hertz. It's not perfectly cut off entirely due to the noise floor of the vinyl, but you can see a definite transition point at 20,000 hertz due to the limit of the digital recording on this LP. I can't play the full audio of this record due to copyright, but I'll play a few clips of it so you can see the spectrum graph in relation to the audio. And for the record, no pun intended, my setup this time is an audio-technica ATLP120 turntable with the preamp removed. It has an audio-technica AT95E cartridge. And I'm using this Technics receiver as my preamp, and it's going into my computer's sound card. Computer is sitting over there. And I'm recording this at 96 kHz sampling rate, 32-bit digital recording. Next is this analog recorded LP from 1971, and there's one track in particular that it's entirely synthesizers, which is a perfect test for the frequency response of vinyl because it's not limited to the frequency response of the microphones that were normally used in recording studios back then. So that's an ideal test for the frequency response of vinyl. From 1971 on an analog recording featuring analog synthesizers, and I think you'll be able to see the difference right away between it and what you saw with the digital recording. And since YouTube is not capable of sampling rates above 48 kHz, I will make this available in the description as a download of a 96 kHz sampling rate 24-bit digital lossless FLAC recording of this track. Thank you.
Thank you.